Says Lee County was lax on permitting after Hurricane Ian. The feds want to remove the flood insurance discount homeowners have been getting for years now.
Now, two North Fort Myers sisters can't even get into their home 18 months after the storm because of a permitting issue. Only NBC2's Dave Elias went with an independent building inspector to get a look at what's going on.
Well, you may recall 18 months ago, we introduced you to two widowed North Fort Myers sisters who have been living in this FEMA trailer after Hurricane Ian ripped apart the backside of their home. Well, they hired someone to do the work, and apparently the person didn't do it properly. And now they can't get back inside because of some strict code enforcement.
His logo said, licensed and insured. Okay. We trusted him to take care of everything. We never had to deal with this ourselves. Mm-hmm. You pay people and you trust them.
That's where Roseanne and Paula went wrong.
I put it in my GPS and we got in the car and went to where he was supposed to be. It was a lot for travel trailers. Oh. He's long gone.
They're stuck with shoddy work.
We've been painting and doing flooring and putting up blinds, making curtains. Ready to move back into.
The county won't approve the work. An independent building inspector, Rob Stewart, took a look for himself.
I don't believe that your home is 50% damaged to the point where you would be stopped from working.
Even inspecting underneath the home.
In terms of the amount of support, I believe it's fine.
Noting the county appears to be enforcing its strict building back stronger obligation that FEMA wants to see.
Because that's what the county wants and that's what FEMA wants is going through these processes.
The sisters have exhausted their finances and they're now working with Lee Cares to meet the building codes.
Is this common where people had somebody they thought was going to do a good job and failed?
Absolutely. I've seen that time and time again where people are have storm brain and then they hire someone that's not a licensed contractor.
As for Roseanne and Paula, FEMA has given them 6 more months to live in their FEMA trailer.
We have done what we thought we needed to
We've
do.
We've gone in circles.
Waiting now for the county to okay the work.
As you can see, they had their electrical box here ready to go. They say as soon as they get the thumbs up on that permit, they can hook up the electric and then it's home sweet home. In North Fort Myers, Dave Elias, NBC2.